Hi everybody, my name is Lyndon, and in this video we're going to do another type of text reveal, this time using a simulation effect called CC Ball Action. So let's go ahead and make a new composition, full HD, 30 FPS, 150 frames. Okay, and then make some text. So for this effect to work, we're going to duplicate this layer, Control D, and under the underneath layer we're going to call this one text or final text, and on the layer above we're going to call that particles. So the effect we're using is called CC Ball Action. So click and drag this one onto the particles layer. So the way CC Ball Action works, it looks at the alpha of the layer that you applied it to. So in this case, it's particle reveal. Then it divides up the alpha based on a grid spacing. So if we look at the grid spacing here, we can lower this to 2, make it a little bit more clear. And it makes little tiny spheres according to that grid spacing. Then what you can do, you can use the scatter control, increase the scatter, and then you get little particles that are going to form over the alpha. And then you can inverse the direction and you can have them form basically on the alpha. So in this case, we're going to turn off final text and just animate scatter, and then we're also going to animate the instability state in a moment. But first, if you wanted to use this as a 3D effect, you can do so. So if you have a camera and rotate around, you can see this does actually work in 3D, and these are actual particles, which is very, very convenient if you wanted to do something more interesting with your camera animation. For this though, we're not going to use a camera, so I'm just going to go ahead and delete it. Okay, so at the very beginning, let's animate the scatter to be at the maximum value. Set a keyframe there. And then we'll go to frame 120, and set this back to 0. So as the particles come in, they're going to form over that alpha, which in this case is the particle reveal. But there is one issue here. So particle reveal, even with a grid spacing of 2, it doesn't look particularly clean. And even if we reduce this to 1 or lower, you can go to 0, it's going to look a little bit aliased. So even at 0, we can have a lot of particles, but the edge is very, very rough. So we have to have a secondary layer to be able to blend the layer we're using for the particles and then the original text layer. This would also work if you have a more complicated font with maybe thinner parts of the letters. So the next thing is, if we wanted to make this look a little bit more interesting with the motion, we can animate the instability state. So we can go right to the beginning, animate the instability state, maybe with 2 full revolutions, and then click U on your keyboard, and then click K, and it will snap to that other keyframe that we had for the scatter, and then change the instability state back to 0. So between those 2 keyframes, the particles will kind of spin around a couple times before they land on their target. Let's play this. So we got the particles spinning around, and then all of a sudden, they're just going to snap when they arrive on the last keyframe. So if you go to frame 120 and then click the page up key a few times, you can step backwards. We need to slow this down and kind of ease out that motion. So we're going to select the scatter channel and the instability state channel, click the graph editor, select both of those keyframes there, and then use the easy ease command. So what this is going to do is it's going to slow them down as they come in and form over the letters. It's going to look a little bit more natural. So the next thing is, like I mentioned, we need to blend these 2 layers together. And the way we're going to do that is just with a simple opacity fade. So click the T key, and on frame 120, this particle layer needs to be turned off. So we're going to animate the opacity channel. We're going to go backwards. So here is 0. Step backwards 2 frames with the page up key, and then set that to 100%. So then it's going to fade off. And then we're going to do the opposite with the final text layer. So turn that on, click T, set the opacity to be at 0% at frame 118, go forward 2 frames with the page down key, and set that to be 100. So between those 2 frames, those particles are going to fade. That's the basic idea of this effect, but I want to go one step further. If I want to have a texture that forms over these words, I can't simply grab a texture and use the alpha mat. And the reason is, if I do that, all of these little particles here are going to look like a texture is simply projected over the top of all the particles, rather than the particles themselves form a texture. So if I want to use that, let me load in a texture first. Grab this one. So I have a texture here. If I drag this down, at the very end, I can use this grunge texture, and I can set the alpha matte to that final text layer. And that's what we'd imagine it working as. But unfortunately, we can't do the same thing for the particles layer. So if I try to do that, I set that to the alpha matte, you might notice if you look closely at some of the particles that fly by, they don't actually keep the same texture. And it might not be noticeable for something that's more of a noisy grunge pattern, but if you had something that's a clear image, it would look pretty unconvincing if you had that texture simply projected over all the particles. So the way that we're gonna do this, click on the first particles layer, click the U key so you can see your keyframes. So you need to go to the very first keyframe that you animated. In this case, it's at frame 0, but it might not be for you. You need to go to the CC ball action effect and do Control X. This is going to cut the effect. Then we need to grab our texture and pull it underneath the particles layer. Then with both of those selected, the particles and the texture, we're going to pre-compose them. So right click and pre-compose or Control Shift C and just call this particles with texture. So now if we go inside this comp, we can set the grunge texture to use the alpha matte of the text layer. So this is the same thing that we had before on the other layer. And you notice there is no ball action effect. It's static like it was with the other text layer. So now after we're done, go all the way back to the very first frame again that you started animating this and simply paste the effect back. So Control V. So the CC ball action effect is going to work on a solid layer. And by pre-composing it, we have made this particle reveal text, but we've implemented it with a texture. So now anytime the CC ball action goes on this, it's going to take pieces out of this alpha and move them with each individual sphere. So it's going to be the correct result. Instead of having a texture that's projected, each texture is split up amongst the many, many spheres, and then they're all going to move independently. Okay, so now we have that working with the texture. I'm going to make an adjustment layer. We'll call this CC for color correction. I'm going to add a curves effect. And then just add a little bit of contrast, or maybe quite a bit of contrast. Really pop those colors. So that looks pretty neat. I like that. Another thing that we can do, if you are unhappy with using perfect spheres, maybe if you wanted to break that up a little bit, you could easily add a turbulent displacement effect to the particles with texture comp. We can use turbulent displace. So with this effect, you'd want to change the size to be as low as it can go, which I believe is 2. And the amount, you can do whatever you'd like for the amount. So we could do something like 100. And if you zoom in, you can see each one is a little bit crinkled. If you go ahead and then change the complexity, if you increase that, you get more and more detail on those edges. So it depends on what kind of effect you wanted to achieve. This kind of looks like little bits of ripped paper. If you went with a lower complexity, it might look more like petals or something like that forming on the text. Okay, so this is almost done, but there's one last issue. If I zoom out here to 100% and then just play this, unfortunately, there's no motion blur, and motion blur is something that we would need to have. And on all the previous examples, there was no need for motion blur because nothing was actually transforming the screen. Everything was just static. So the issue is here is none of these layers are actually moving. None of the transform, like the position, scale, rotation is working. So if we try to use motion blur by enabling motion blur in the comp and enabling it for the switches for each layer, it's not actually going to do anything. So in order to get these particles to have motion blur, we need to use an effect called CC force motion blur. So you can just type in force motion blur, put this underneath our color correction curves here, and we can see that with that added, it's going to look at the pixels that move and kind of blur them in the same direction that the pixels are moving. Unfortunately, though, this effect is very, very heavy. It's very, very, it takes a long time to render. And if you zoom in with 8 samples, that's not really enough because we can see that same piece, that same particle there being repeated 8 times. So in order for this effect to look decent, I would suggest a value of around 24, so you get a much smoother result. You could try something like 16 as well, but it is really going to improve the overall look of your animation. Alright guys, so that was all I wanted to show in this video, so thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed it, please subscribe. Alright, so thank you and have a good day.